Hi, this is the Ask Patrick series. The question is by Krishna. The question is, what should be the strategy for CAT preparation for those who cannot afford coaching? Very frankly, I don't see a difference between a strategy for preparation for a person who can afford coaching and who cannot afford coaching. So actually, it doesn't matter. One is you can follow any couple of faculties who are known on the portal. You can follow me. That's one aspect. Maybe you can follow one more person, whichever it is there, but a couple of faculties who are known to crack the examination and a portal. That's first step. They will always give you a plan for preparation. I mean, there will be a plan. So even if you go to my portal on my YouTube channel, you will see, or on my Quora answers, you will see that there are a lot of answers with regards to how to prepare for CAT, what you need to do, your plan, your structure, a lot of things are there. Go and read through it. I mean, I recently posted a video on preparation for CAT if you're starting from May. Similarly, I have a lot of videos with regards to CAT preparation in my portal or my Quora answer. Go back, go through it, read through it. Okay, make a proper plan based on whatever I put and start preparing. The first step is to complete the syllabus. The syllabus completion is make a proper plan. So that means if I'm starting from now, maybe next 2 or 3 months I'll try to complete the syllabus. How will you plan? How will you prepare? How many topics per week? What should you do per day? Make a plan. If you have a written down plan, you'll be able to do it much, much better. Second very important thing for a person not joining coaching is try to restrict yourself to only one or two sources. Because you don't have any material, people tend to look at many, many material online. But there's a problem in that. When you refer to too many sources, it leads to confusion. And because look at every person or every individual who is, you know, explaining it to you, he has his own ideas and own ways of doing it, right? From start to the end. So if you follow him from the start to the end, you'll be able to master his technique. But if you only follow one topic from him, one topic from someone else, one topic from a third person, there's a high chance that may lead to confusion, which is not really good. So focus maximum on one or two person to, or a one or two notes to complete the syllabus. Once the syllabus is complete, then you try to focus on method. But right now, for the first step, focus on completing the syllabus. That's what I would say. Make a plan. Focus on completing the syllabus as far as possible. Apart from mathematics syllabus and a DILR syllabus which is there, also ensure that you read regularly. Solve puzzles, do a little bit of calculations. If you do this regularly, it will definitely help you to improve. So try doing this 3 regularly, and I'm sure you will improve with regards to your whole concept of, you know, cracking the examination. But before everything else, make a plan for yourself. That is very important. And once you make a plan for yourself, try to follow it. I hope that helps. Thank you.